Chase Lehocki here with the Blue Futon. At the Netflix world, we have another Netflix original movie, End of the Road. Queen Latifah, Ludacris, can they save this Netflix spell? Let's find out. So, End of the Road, what's it about? Very simple premise. Road trip movie, California, Texas. However, when they stop in Arizona, they witness a murder and there's some money under the sink. Let's take some of this money, but however, Mr. Cross, who is part of the cartel, wants his money back, and we're going to figure out what is in these back roads of Arizona. So, did I like this movie? No, this is dog shit 101. Thank you, Netflix. Come again for another dog shit movie on this fucking docket. Holy fucking shit. This movie is bad. You can say, is it acted bad? No, it is the writing. If you look at the writer of this movie, every single movie he does is a race bait movie. And this is 100% a race bait movie. But guys. I've driven through California, Arizona, Nevada, Utah, Colorado, New Mexico, Texas, Louisiana, Alabama, Georgia, Florida, Kentucky, Tennessee, Iowa, Kansas, Nebraska. I've driven through most of the Midwest, not the East Coast really, but West Coast all the way through. And you know what? I've been through back roads. I mean fucking back roads of a lot of these states. And you know what? I've never met a Nazi. I've never met someone with a tattoo SS on their faces. I'm sorry. Where do these fucking people exist? Do these screenwriters really think that they just exist fucking everywhere? And then when they're in Arizona, there's these big country boys that are literally just going to run people off the road and hit cars just on purpose. Like, what the fuck are we writing about? These just race bait movies and this the costume design and what we do with this dialogue is just so fucking atrocious. I mean, there's a scene also in the movie with gunplay where it's easily 50 yards away. Someone is shooting a shotgun from, like, inside a car in another side of the car, and the shotgun just hits the rear view mirror. Do you know what a shotgun does? Seriously, it is such bad writing, bad directing, bad cinematography, bad CGI, bad everything in this movie. The only positive things I can say in this movie are some of the acting by Ludacris and Queen Latifah. Sure, and the family element dynamic is believable in this movie. But Boo Bridges, whoever his name is, the scenarios, everything in this movie is fucking dog shit awful. I mean, I'm just tired of these race bait movies where, you know, white boys in the middle of Arizona are always going to terrorize people. Or there's Nazis just in the fucking desert just living their life in the middle of Arizona. I'm sorry, like I said, I've been through back roads of California, Texas, Arizona, New Mexico. Where are these getting these people at? Seriously. I don't know if this L.A. fucking niche thinks that, like, every other part of the world, there's Nazis just around every corner. There's white supremacy just around the fucking corner. Like, yup, there they are. It's just fucking atrocious. So, bad in the movie. Everything I can really say except for the family dynamic of Queen Latifah and Ludacris, everything else. The acting, by most parts, is atrocious. Especially this scene where it's like, you're gonna double cross Mr. Cross. It's like, really? The directing is not good at all. The writing, not good at all. The car chases, not good at all. It's rinse, wash, repeat. Rinse, wash, repeat. And some of this, that cracker over there, it's like, this dialogue is third grade bullshit. It is Twitter, Washington Post, Atlantic, fucking Mother Jones bullshit. So End of the Road will receive a 0.5 out of 5 of futons, which equals that 10%. Netflix, what the fuck? Now I know why you're firing half your woke staff. I really do. So let's see the critics and user scores actually gave this one. So you have critics, a 28% with 18 of them. Audience score, 20% with over 100. Let's see what the critics actually said, if they're like really bad or they're like the 50%. We have a B. Someone's giving it a B. They don't watch a lot of movies, guys. I'm like over like 200 movies this year. So, yeah. And we have a D-. We have a 3 out of 4, a 2 out of 5, a 4 out of 5, a point, a 1.5 out of 5. Yeah, this is not a good movie. These people give it a 3 out of 4. What's a 3 out of 4? Violent and entertaining. New York Times gave it a positive. Why am I not shocked when I literally just said New York Times before this? What do I know? I guess I know what the media is going to think about this movie. Guys, when you have a jersey with BLM jersey, and look what BLM's doing, embezzling millions of money to buy mansions and doing nothing for the black community. Who lives matter at that point? Anyway, we got a 10, we got this 20, and we got this 28. Chase Talk with the Blue Food Tone. Like, comment, subscribe. Let me know what you think. It's Blue Tone Utopia. Your Blue Tone. Thank you for watching. Have a fantastic day. Oh, what are you saying about what lives matter? You know what? I'm sick and tired of any organization that says they're going to do something and they don't do shit. Have integrity. If you're going to do something, do it. Don't fucking put something under a banner and fucking hide behind that banner and do absolutely nothing except for your own fucking pocketbooks. Dirty fucking politics. That's what's wrong with the world.